Good evening, everybody. Hope everybody's having a nice, pleasant, guess it's summer evening, isn't it? Tonight, we got the great pleasure of having Ryan Jones with us. He's got some very high-powered option trading strategies that you're probably going to be interested in looking at. He's got 33 years of trading background, so you're probably going to get some very good information. So with that, Ryan, welcome to the Candlestick Forum. We're anxious to see your information tonight.
I appreciate it, Steve, and thank you so much for having me. I am super excited being here. I had to rearrange all sorts of things to make it on this. That's how important you guys are. So I'm going to go ahead and just get started because I have a ton of information to share with you tonight, and there's no way that I can exhaustively get through everything that I would like to share. So I'm going to get through as much as I possibly can, and then we'll go from there. Now, the title of this is How One Trader Turned $3,000 into $54,141 in just 2 months. And that's, you know, people are going to see that and they're like, okay, well, yeah, that was a one-off. That was some guy getting lucky, this and that. Or, you know, maybe it's not even real. But it is, and that is what I am going to be covering today. This is what I'm going to show you. Today I'm going to show you the safest, and I use that word hesitantly because I don't want anyone to think that I'm saying there's no risk, because there absolutely always is. This is trading. So I think this group is well educated in that. But there are levels of risk, right? And so on a scale of risk, this is one of the safest, fastest ways to geometrically grow your account. And it's not at all what you might think it is. And so before I get into the details of this approach, I need to lay a general foundation because most of you have probably never heard of what I'm about to show you. Then after I lay the foundation, so you have to bear with me, it absolutely has to be laid. Then I'm going to give you some practical application of the foundation behind my option strategy that I'm going to share with you tonight. So the next 30 to 45 minutes actually might be the most important 30 to 45 minutes of your trading career. And I get this all the time when people first learn about how I approach trading from a principles, from the standpoint of the principles that I use and the foundations that I use and how we grow account. So this is not about getting lucky on a few trades. It's not about making some monster trades. This is the most methodical, consistent, reliable, logical, a lot of words there, but it is the most logical and proven way to build wealth in trading, bar none. And the best part is that anyone can achieve this. And if depending on how much experience you have with options, you may have a little bit of trouble keeping up, but I'm telling you, no matter where you are in your option trading career or your experience, it's only a matter of exposure. And the more you expose yourself, the more you're going to understand that the light bulb will click. If it doesn't click tonight, don't worry, it will, the more you expose yourself to it. And I don't care where you are in your trading experience. I don't care how many times you have failed to reach your trading goals over the years. What you're going to learn today, and I say this again hesitantly, but it's mind-boggling and almost unbelievable if it actually wasn't happening. But I'll show you example after example of how you can consistently and geometrically grow your account. In fact, what I'm going to show you is how Jake out of Texas took his $3,000 account. Actually, he had less than $3,000 account and grew it into $54,141 in just 2 months, trading exactly what I'm going to show you today. And just to show you that it's real, I want to show you an email exchange that I had with Jake. I'll call him Jake. And I'm not going to read through all this, but let me just give you a little bit of background. Jake contacted me and said, hey, this is what I've done with your strategy. And I've got some questions. And I said, hey, you know, that's a great And so we had about a week-long conversation back and forth, and he was asking questions, and I was congratulating him because it was an excellent excellent little run that he had. And basically, at the end of that week, I said, "Hey, can I use you as an inspiration for other traders to show them that what you did can be done?" And he says, "Yeah." And I said, "Okay, I'll come up with, based on our conversation, I'll come up with a comment and I'll send it to you, and you can approve it or change it or whatever." And so I sent it. Basically, he's been trading for 20 years. He grew his $3,000 account into $31,000 when I emailed him, $31,000 in less than 2 months. And so I sent him that, and this is what he sent back. He says, "Ryan, I'm okay with using what you sent, but I work for a large bank, and so I don't want any blowback whatsoever. So if you'll just change my first name to Jake." So I can't tell you what his first name is, but it's Jake G out of Texas. And then he goes on and he says, "Oh, and by the way, my account's now at $54,141." And so that quickly he grew his account from that. So that just shows you, after trading for 20 years, 20 years, and had spent tens of thousands of dollars on trading strategies, option strategies, and trading educational courses, this is the first time he had experienced any kind of real success. And it wasn't until he started trading this options approach. So I want to give that to you so that you will pay attention to what I'm going to show you today, and don't just put this approach into the same category as what you've seen in everything else. Okay, his success is real. He grew his account by 1800% in 2 months. Now, to put that into perspective, there are only a handful of stocks that have grown by more than 1800% over the last 10 years. And he did it methodically, consistently, and safely in just 2 months. So think about that for a minute. Only a handful of stocks produced over 10 years what Jake was able to achieve in just 2 months with what I'm going to show you in the options today. And this is what my option strategy can do for you. It can put you in the position geometrically. I'm having trouble with that word today. Geometrically grow your account, and you're about to see why. Okay, so the first thing, that's the general foundation. Now I'm going to start laying a more specific foundation. The first thing that usually shocks seasoned option traders is when I tell them I never, ever reference any Greek when making a trading decision. I'll give you just a brief history of my option trading career. I started trading options when I was 16, didn't have a lot of money. I lost what I had. Took me a while to build up enough money to start trading again, about a year and a half, and I started buying options, and immediately I had success. Within about a month, I doubled my account, and then about a month later, I lost it all. And that happened a couple of times, and then I started figuring out, okay, you got to sell options, right? And so I started selling options, and I did okay for a short period of time, and then I lost everything. In about 6 months, it took me about 6 months to lose everything selling options. So I'm like, okay, if I can't make money buying options and I can't make money selling options, what in the world is going on? And so what I did was I basically scrapped everything, and I grabbed onto options like a pit bull on a raw steak, and I would not let go until I understood the basic foundation of options. And so one of the things that came out of that is I don't use Greeks. Now, that ever, by the way, like never, haven't touched a Greek in 25 years. All right, so they aren't necessary. I know there's a lot of gurus out there, a lot of books, and they all talk about the Greeks, blah, 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 but they aren't necessary. And it isn't that you can't be profitable using Greeks. I don't want to give that impression off. There are traders who have had limited success and they use Greeks. But the fact is, using Greeks actually limits your understanding of how to create unbelievable probabilities in your option trades. It's actually much more simple than that. So you have to start thinking outside of the box. And that's what I did, is I started thinking outside of the box, and I simplified things and created Foundation. So the second thing that usually shocks traders is how logical my option approach really is. Here is my secret formula to unbelievable option trades week in and week out. If you just take this and you start playing with it on your own, you'll be able to eventually figure out what I'm doing just from this next slide. Okay, here it is. It's just going to blow your mind at how complicated this is. Okay, are you ready? I take one bearish neutral trade, a bearish neutral trade in options, and I combine it with a bullish neutral trade. And if you do it right, that can equal unbelievable probabilities. And it really is that simple. The rest is details, all right? But this is the concept that if you hang on to this, you, as the foundation of your option trading, you have the ability to experience tremendous success. Now, I'm going to give you several examples of this actually in a minute of what this looks like. But before I do that, I need to give you the third absolutely mind-blowing thing that shocks traders. And this is the one that most traders have never heard of, because everybody in the industry focuses on where to get in, where to get out, making big trades, being right, et cetera, et cetera. And there's nothing wrong with that. It has its place. But this is an absolute must. I don't care what you're trading. Even if you never trade a single option trade of mine ever, whatever it is that you're trading, you have to apply what I'm about to show you. This third thing actually has nothing to do with options directly. It's a numbers thing. But certain option strategies, including mine, work best with it. Okay, and what is that? Well, I'm going to explain to you what it is by telling you this. If you can average just $100 per week with my simple option strategy and apply my very specialized compounding plan, then you can grow a very small account into as much as, I know it doesn't seem believable, but 3.7 million in just 5 years. Okay, so the key is being able to average $100 a week, that's it, and then properly compound it. That's $5,200 a year that compounds into possibly as much as 3.7 million in 5 years. Now, to put this into perspective, the best performing stock over the past 7 years was Netflix, providing a whopping 6,000% return. Basically, if you would have invested $1,000 into Netflix 7 years ago, that $1,000 would be worth $60,000 today if you would have held on to it. Most, even if you would have bought Netflix 7 years ago, most of you would have been out long ago. So that's a huge return. That was the best performing stock over the last 7 years. But if you average just $100 a week for 5 years and apply my powerful conservative compounding plan, you can safely grow possibly as little as $1,000 into a mind-blowing 370,000%. And by this time, I usually lose some people. You know, that's a 6,000% return on a 6,000% return, to give you the perspective. And I usually lose people along about now because they say, oh, there's no way. This doesn't compute. These numbers don't compute. This is all hype, et cetera, et cetera. But that's because you've never seen or heard of this kind of growth potential before. And I could spend a few minutes talking about my experiences and some of my world records that I have held in actual worldwide trading contests. But I don't want to waste time on that right now. What I want to do is I want to show you why that is the case. It is simple math. Okay, this is not some tremendous stock picking ability. It's not some tremendous strategy. It is purely a compounding mathematical algorithm that you apply as an active trader. Now, if you find that unbelievable, bear in mind that Jake from Texas has been growing his account at a rate of 670,000% in 5 years, not 370,000%. So he's actually experiencing that rate. And I have an account going right now that I'm actually experiencing a faster rate than that. That I'll not going to talk about in this presentation either. Nonetheless, the combination of my unique option approach hasn't been available very long. This is something where that is brand new, and being able to combine something this powerful with my compounding plan. The compounding has been there. I created the compounding plan back in 1994, and it's been around for a while. But the combination, the key to compounding is low risk, efficient profits that carry low risk. And so the more efficient your strategy, the more effective the compounding is. And it wasn't until very recently that we have really been able to accelerate the efficiency of the option trading. And that's because my approach takes advantage of the unique relationship between Monday, Wednesday, and Friday expiration options in SPY, which has not been available for very long. And it's not available on other markets. It's only available on SPY and SPX. All right, so this is a unique situation. It is unprecedented in any trader's lifetime, investor's lifetime. We truly live in a unique time period. And I would also mention that it is enhanced by the fact that no one charges commissions anymore. And so that also increases the effectiveness of the money management. So this is brand new, the ability to grow your account this efficiently because of this strategy combined with the money management or the compounding. It has been it's tremendous opportunity. So for the past 2 years, basically what I've been doing is I've been focusing on how to create the best option approach according to the Monday, Wednesday, Friday expirations, which provides all sorts of different opportunities that did not exist in the past, and the returns have been spectacular. And better yet, the risks are exceptionally low. Sometimes you can, well, I'm not going to get off on how low some of the risks can be. You can create a more efficient trade with this approach, or you can be a little bit more risky and go for bigger profits, but I'll get into that here in a second. But that is the recipe for explosive growth in your account. It is the only realistic recipe for explosive growth in your account. You don't need to find the next best explosive stock. You don't need to learn necessarily how to be a major stock picking guru. If you have the money management, you can be average and you can geometrically grow your account. But perhaps the best part about my approach with options and this is that with this whole thing, you are never at risk to suffer from a stock market crash again. Today was a massive down day in stocks, and I did very well because of this low risk, high probability option approach. But it's important for you to understand that we're not trying to make a killing with these trades. Okay, we're not trying to make a killing with these trades. We're simply trying to make as much as $100 per week on average. That's it. If we can do that and then safely compound those trades over time, we will be doing far better than the best explosive stock that we've seen in the last 7 years. And it is literally that simple. That is the formula if you want to grow your account geometrically. So how much more realistic is that goal than finding the next blockbuster stock like Netflix? Pun intended, by the way. Right? It's a lot more realistic. But I'm going to blow your mind one last time before we get into the details of my option strategy. Okay? Did you know that you can beat the 6,000% Netflix return over the past 7 years if you are able to average just $10 a week with my option strategy? Now, it's important that you understand that I'm talking about my option strategy. You can't take the same statement and overlay it on any strategy out there because, again, it's all has to do with the risk reward metrics, and the better risk reward metrics you have, the more efficient the compounding is. And so when you have super high efficient risk reward metrics, you can make this statement. If you're trading a stock trading or a directional trading options strategy where you're risking, you know, $300, $400, $500 on a trade or whatever the case is, or you don't have very good overall risk reward metrics, this is not going to be a true statement. So this is solely based on what I'm going to be showing you today. You can still compound with everything else, you just can't compound as efficiently. Okay, and that's the key. So if you just average $10 a week and then compound that $10 a week, you can beat the best performing stock over the last 7 years. This is why I strongly encourage everybody to learn the trades that I'm about to show you. Okay, because they're not, some of them are really good, but you don't have to be really good. So do whatever it takes. And bear in mind, everything that I show you today is based on actual fills. Okay, I don't do hypotheticals. I know a lot of people talk about track records and this and that, and they're hypothetical and this. I don't do hypotheticals. I'm not going to show you any hypothetical today. All right, so remember, my secret to low-risk, high-probability trades lies in combining two synergistic trades together. That being one bearish neutral trade plus one bullish neutral trade equals unbelievable probabilities. That's the concept. That's what I'm going to show you today. So with that, here is my first trade example. Now this begins with my bearish neutral trade. All right, and it is, by the way, I'll just let you know, I'll get into this here a little bit more. It's a diagonal spread. If you're not familiar with what a diagonal spread is, it's where you have your short option or option legs have different strikes and different expirations than your long option leg or legs. All right, and that's what I'm doing with this. I told you it's a relationship between the Monday, Wednesday, and Friday expiration options. So this is my bearish neutral trade, and I start with this one. And you're going to notice here that the minimum profit on this trade to the downside is $250. So if you take a look and go all the way down, left side of the graph shows at 310, but it's a $250 profit. So even if stocks crash, which they did today, the minimum gain on this particular trade is $250. Now you'll also notice that the loss to the upside is also $250. So you have a 1-1 win loss ratio on this bearish neutral trade, right? What creates a positive overall risk reward metrics with this trade and this trade alone, without adding anything else to it, is where the break-even point is. There is what I call an equal movement ratio. I'm not going to get into that today either. I told you there's a lot. I've been doing this a long time, so I apologize. But there's an equal movement ratio. And you take where the market is and you calculate what the profit or loss is going to be if the market moves up 1 point versus it moving down 1 point, vice versa, and then go to 2 points on either side, and then go to 3 points and 4 points, et cetera, et cetera. Well, you're going to make money on both sides of the equation here up until about 324. And the market was trading at around 319 when this particular trade was placed on. And so the market go all the way to 324 before it hits a break even at based on when it was placed. Okay, so, or I'm sorry, SPY was trading just under 22 when the market, when this was filled. And then the market would have to go up to 324. So there's your neutral aspect to this trade. The bulk of it is bearish, but there is a neutral aspect to this trade, and that is why. Okay, now, if the market stays in a tight trading range, this trade will make between $100 to $200. That's really good. You don't start losing $200 until the market goes to about 328 to 330. And that has a relatively low probability of happening. It's not impossible. And if this is the only trade that you place, obviously, in a bullish market, if the market is consistently bullish, then you'll consistently lose with this trade, even though the probabilities are are positive. Okay, so the trade, this particular trade, ends in 4 days, or ended at the time that I placed it on, ended in 4 days. The stats on the trade are about 60% probability if you're not in a massive bull market. All things equal, it's about 60% probability of success with an average win-loss ratio of over 3-1. The max win-loss ratio is 1-1, but the average win-loss ratio is about 3-1. So that's where the positive probabilities come into play. This trade alone has solid probabilities associated with it. You don't have to do anything else, and you have already put the probabilities in your favor. But what I do is I then add a synergistic bullish neutral trade to it. And this is the one that I added. And again, everything here is actual fills, not hypothetical. So this one, as you can tell, is going to make money if the market moves up. It's going to lose money if the market moves down. If the market stays the same, it's going to make just a little bit of money. So there's the neutral part. But you'll notice that the risk to the downside is actually less than the profit potential to the downside of the first trade. The profit potential to the downside of the first trade was $250. The loss potential on this trade is only about $170. So no matter what, when you combine these two trades together, you're going to make money if the market moves down. It's not a huge amount, but it is going to make money if the market moves down. On the flip side of that, though, you'll notice that the profit potential to the upside is not quite as much as the risk to the upside from the bearish neutral trade. The risk to the upside on the bearish neutral trade was $250. The profit potential, the minimum profit potential on this trade to the upside, is $170. So worst case scenario, you have about an $80 risk to the upside based on how this trade structure is put together. Here is the combination of these two trades being placed together. Okay, the profit range from this combination is huge. It's going to make money no matter what, period, end of story, if the market crashes. The high peak profit zone is going to be between 315 and about 326-ish. And then the profit begins to tick down before you hit the break-even, projected break-even level at about 329. And then, even then, if the market were to skyrocket over a four-day period up to that level, is all the way to the max risk, you're only talking about an $80 risk on the trade. So these are tremendous probabilities when you know how to combine these two trades together, okay? So again, the minimum profit to the downside of this trade is what is considered the overall credit on the trade. We're able to put the entire trade on at a total net credit, and that becomes the minimum profit to the downside. SPY can go to zero. You're still going to make whatever the credit is on these trades. So here's my question to you. Do you think if you put on a similar trade like this every week that you might be able to average $10 a week? I mean, look at what the profit zone is, upwards of $200 for a large range. Max risk is $80 to the down, to the upside, and you have no risk to the downside. Yeah, the probability is that you'll do much better than $10 a week, but that's all you have to do. If you put on just this type of trade every week, that's all you have to do to achieve and beat the 7-year record of Netflix. All right. Now, this example is not the most simple application of the concept. I'm going to reveal both of these trades were, but I do want to tell you that it's not the most simple version of applying the logic of this concept. All right. So again, this is a bearish neutral trade. This is the one that I showed you. And it's selling one Friday expiration 318 call, selling one Friday expiration call, and then buying two Monday expiration 322 calls. and that was done for a credit of $2.28. So I said 250, it's 228. $228 is the minimum gain to the downside. That's the credit on this trade. This is the bearish trade. Those were actual fills on this trade. So then what I did was I added the bullish neutral trade. And what is the bullish neutral trade? And I'll pull both of these back up here in a second. The bullish neutral trade was selling one Friday expiration 325 call, selling a Friday expiration 326 call, and buying a Monday expiration 324 call, and that was for a debit of 170. So that's the max risk to the downside. Now, I don't have enough time to go into the details of why I choose the strikes that I choose in the relationship that I'm choosing. It's much more technical, but the concept is what I want you to focus on tonight because it's a very, very powerful concept. Fill in the details later, basically, is what I would suggest, all right? So I add the synergistic bullish neutral trade to it. That's what this is, and that's how those two work together, right? So this is the two trades together. The 318, 321, 322 spread, that's one spread. It's entered in as one order at a credit of 225 or 230 or whatever it is around where it's trading at the time. And then the second spread is a 325, 326, 324 spread, all right? So the long is two Monday expiration 324 calls against two strikes that are higher than what the long is, but those strikes expire on Friday, okay? So again, the explanation for why I choose exactly these strikes and the relationship between them is way above what I can cover in today's presentation. But you can see where one bearish adding one bullish together that are synergistically structured can produce tremendous, tremendous probabilities. But you can be much simpler with how you apply this concept. You don't have to do that example. So for example, here's a much more simple example of this. If you go short one Friday expiration, 321 call, and then long just one Monday expiration, 324 call. And you can do that from a credit of 78 cents, okay? And again, nothing here is hypothetical. Everything that I show you, I place on. This particular one I placed on specifically for the presentation because I don't normally do them this simple, and there's a reason for that, and I'll show you in a second. But I do want to show you that you can simplify it. It's a very simple concept. So the short strike is less than the long strike. It's the short expires on Friday, the long expires on Monday. And you'll notice that the short strike is at the money at the time that this was placed. Okay? There's a simple beginning point for the bearish side of this. Then the bullish side of this is a short one Friday expiration 327 call and a long one Monday expiration 326 call from a debit of 74 cents. And you'll notice that that is a bullish trade, right? So you have one bearish, one bullish. You'll notice that the debit here is less than the credit of this trade. My bearish is a credit of 78 cents, and my bullish is a debit of 74 cents. Now, if I wanted to, I could switch that. Just as a side note, I could switch that, and I could say, okay, I want there to be no risk to the upside, and whatever risk that the trade has, I want it to be to the downside. If I wanted to do that, I could do that. But I like to create a credit as much as I possibly can because I just don't like losing money if the stocks move down. All right, so one bullish, one bearish, one's a 78 cent credit, and the other's a 74 cent debit. That gives you a total credit of 4 cents, and this is what this particular trade looks like. Now, you're not going to make very much money with this trade on the way down. If the market tanks like it did, you're only going to make $4, all right? But what's the probability that the market's going to tank every week like it did, for example, this week, at least so far. This trade, by the way, is only going to make $4 this week. That's it. But last week, this trade did very well. Not last week, the week before. Last week, the market skyrocketed to the upside. And you'll notice here that there's a lot of room for the market to move to the upside. And the risk on this particular trade is to the upside, but again, it's very small. So small may be relative. It's about $100. Actually, it's a little more than $100, but the realistic probability is that it would be less than $100 because the market would have to move all the way to 330 in just 4 days when the market was trading at around 320. All right, so not impossible, but it absolutely can do that. So this is a more simple version, and I do want to mention one last thing. I don't want to get into the weeds too much, but you have to be careful when you're dealing with SPY options because volatility, this is not true with other options, other stocks, other options and stocks. It's only true with stock index markets, and I'm going to mention it, but I cover this in much more detail in other places. But in SPY, as the market moves up, volatility comes out of the option prices. Period. End of story. You can bank on it. It's going to happen. If SPY moves down like it did today, volatility is going to be infused into options. Period. End of story. You can bank on it. If SPY stagnates, volatility will come out of option prices. Period. End of story. You can bank on it. Except when they're waiting for a huge announcement, which, for example, they came out with an announcement today about this interest rates and whatnot. Their volatility was remaining in the option prices until that came out. And then they went down, but then stocks tanked, and sure enough, it went back up. So I mention that because you have to be very careful with this, what I call a dead zone. And you can put these trades together, and if you don't know exactly what you're doing, you can get yourself into a little bit of trouble. So that's why I did want to mention that. You don't want to just put these trades together haphazardly. You definitely want to understand more about what you're doing. But one of the great benefits of this particular type of pattern is that you can place this trade at once with one order. You can place up to four legs in an option spread, so you can place this as one order. And you don't have to worry about two different option spreads or getting filled on two different option spreads. You can do it the bearish side and the bullish side all at once. Okay, so there are certain option patterns, if you will. Just like stocks have patterns, there are certain option patterns that create these setups, and I call them TPO patterns or triple play option patterns. And the certain option patterns that create these setups are based on low volatility markets, high volatility markets, and transitional volatility markets. And that's what, hence the name triple play options, because there are different patterns that work differently with different types of market volatility. And again, I know that might seem like I'm starting to get a little confusing there, but trust me, it's only a matter of exposure. It comes out. So this particular one, as a combined one, is a transitional pattern. Now, I do want to mention that you can apply these patterns in any kind of market action, and they're all going to work to some degree, but some patterns are more efficient in low volatility, some patterns are more efficient in higher volatility, and some patterns are more efficient in transitional volatility. Okay, but the great thing about the patterns is that you can structure them to lean more bearish, neutral, or bullish. A lot of my clients have IRA accounts or retirement accounts that have stock positions. And so they actually take this and they structure a trade where they are providing a bit of a hedge for their stock portfolio. So you can make this more bearish, you can make it more neutral, you can make it more bullish. And so, for example, here's a trade that was placed on a couple of days ago that was more neutral. There's no risk to the downside. Risk to the upside is very small. It's a little bit bigger than the other ones that I showed you, but look at the profit zone here. A huge profit zone and peaks out at almost $300 at one point. And so you can structure these, right? The break-even level on this was at 332, upwards at around 332. And with 4 days left on this trade, that gave this particular trade pattern a 90% probability of success. And that's huge when you consider the risk-reward ratio with this particular trade, okay? And again, remember, the great thing about these trades is that we aren't trying to make a killing every week. All we need to do is average a little bit of money and then compound it. So let me ask you a question. What are the probabilities that you're going to find the next Netflix, invest $1,000 into it, hold on to the stock for the 7 years, and then make $60,000? What's the probabilities of that happening? Well, it's about as close to zero of a probability, 0% probability, as you can get. I can pretty much tell you everybody on this call is not going to find the next Netflix. And even if you did, you probably wouldn't hold on to it through its peak 7 years later. I could be wrong. There might be one person on here that finds that one stock, but it's not going to happen for the most part, right? But here's the compounding plan. This is all you have to have. Average per week to grow a $1,000 account into these levels. $10 a week can grow $1,000 into $35,000. In 5 years. In 7 years, it's $65,000. $25 a week grows $1,000 into $211,000 in 5 years. It's simple math. Okay, $50 a week grows $1,000 into $845,000 in 5 years. $75 a week, again, with this strategy, not with every strategy out there, specifically with this strategy, grows $1,000 into $1.9 million in 5 years, and $100 a week grows $1,000 into $3.4 million. I'll actually show you how to do that to $3.7 million. In some of my videos, there's different ways of approaching it. But my point being is that you can start off and not do very well and still do really well over time. And the goal is to slowly and methodically, consistently improve that. And believe me, you're going to be tempted to force more profits, force more trades, force bigger profits than you should or need to, and I'm telling you this from experience, but the more you learn, the greater the temptation is at doing that as well. And I want to mention that because you don't need to hit home runs every week. The home run is in the compounding. That's where it's at. So here's a TPO pattern that places on two bullish, and I'm almost done. I'll take questions. Here's a TPO pattern that places on two bullish trades. And then only one bearish trade, but it still carries a small credit. And what this particular trade does, this particular pattern does, is that it has a scenario where the market has to move up. All right, the market has to move up before it gets to its risk zone. Now, if without that, this trade has a 95% probability based on holding onto the trade until the last day. That's because it's not going to lose money if the market moves down. The market has to move up significantly for this to actually realize the break even. But the one special thing about this trade is that the market at the time was trading at about 315, and it needed to move up to 328 in order to reach the break even point. But to do that, it first has to move through the higher profit zone, right? So the market's trading at 315 when the trade was placed on. Before it reaches the risk, it has to move through the bigger profit zone. What that does is that creates astronomical probabilities because it allows you, not always, but almost always, the opportunity to exit the trade at a profit before it ever reaches the risk zone. It's not absolute, but it is going to happen a lot. If the market is moving up, it's going to give you the opportunity to exit the trade before it ever reaches the risk zone. All right, so this is an option pattern, by the way, that is consistently available week in and week out. most of the time. And it's all it is it's one bearish spread. It's that is then added with two bullish spreads instead of just one bullish spread. So it's, again, there's a lot of different ways of doing this, but this can be done consistently for a small credit or even a small debit if you're willing to take a little bit of risk to the downside if the market crashes. This is something that is consistently available. Okay, so let me ask you this. What if you took this trade every week? You think you could average at least $10 a week on this one and grow $1,000 into $35,000 in 5 years? Very good probability of that happening. All right, now, not everyone is going to have the kind of return that Jake G from Texas was able to put together. Part of the reason that he was able to grow his account so fast was due to excessive volatility in stocks during the height of the coronavirus pandemic. So in other words, when the volatility is high, there are some monstrous profitable trades that are available using exactly what I showed you today, which just underscores just how powerful this option approach is. When times are tough, it actually gets better. So you don't have to worry about days like today when stocks were down big. No one else in the industry is going to show you how to do this because I had to figure it out on my own based on my unique approach to options. There's obviously a lot more to this approach that can't come close to being covered in a 45-minute session, but I wanted to at least give you something that you could go and research a little bit on your own. If you want to stick your toes in the water with this approach, I've put together a getting started package for you. It's basically another intro video to my approach to options. Then I go through my triple play introduction video where I talk more in detail about why I pick this, the strikes that I pick, etc. Then I have a quick triple play option starter pattern report. It's basically a quick start guide. And then you can attend one of my live trade sessions, which I hold twice a week. My next one is tomorrow at 11 a.m. Plus, I'm going to show you how to compound your results for astronomical growth. You'll get the exact trade compounding plan. So basically, you're going to get everything for $97 if you want to do this. That's great. If not, that's fine as well. You know, go and research what I've shown you and then, you know, go from there. All right, so that is up. Normally, I give this for a single day. I'll give you a couple of days. I know this is going to be recorded, so you can watch the recording. Maybe you can check out some of the trades that I showed you today, et cetera, et cetera. But nonetheless, the time is limited for this. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and take questions. On what day do you put the trade on? That's a great question, and it doesn't matter. You can begin putting this trade on. It's almost always available. You can begin putting it on Thursday. You can do it on Friday. You can do it on a week, more than a week left to go. You can do it on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. You start get to Wednesday, it's going to be tough to pass Wednesday. It's going to be tough to put on this trade with only 2 days left, but it's very flexible, is my point. What's the minimum time frame? It's generally a week. It's about a week long, somewhere in there. Okay. Do I use weekly SPY options? Yes, I use Monday, Wednesday, Friday expirations. Today, what I focused on was just Friday, Monday relationship, and it's only available in SPY. You cannot get these same trades in other markets because there's not the Friday, Monday relationship. Okay. SPY was down 18 today. What is your recommended trade now? Well, that's why I have the live calls. I have the live calls twice a week, and I show you, and I put the call, I put the trades on live in front of you where you can see. Let's see. That's a long question. You're not over leveraging your account to get to 3.7 million. You're going to be, this is going to be somewhat of an interesting question or answer, but at 3.7 million, you're only trading 260 watts. You go from 1 to 260. At that point, worst case scenario, you're risking less than 1% of your account. So no, you're not over leveraging to grow your account that way. That's why I say it's safe and it's conservative. It's unlike anything else that's out there. I show my trades twice a week. I put on trades every single live call that I do, because there's always something available. When you learn how to do this, the sky's the limit. There's always opportunities. This sounds like something for an IRA account. Yes, it can absolutely be done in an IRA account. Is it a lifetime membership? No, not a lifetime membership. Well, there's a ton of questions here. So I have E-Trade as my broker. Just make sure that my suggestion is that you don't pay commissions. That would be my suggestion, because of, as you saw, you can have two trades that each have three legs apiece, and if you're paying commissions, that can get expensive. Fortunately, they're not doing that. They actually followed the lead of another broker that I've been with for several years. So, all right, let me see if I can. The questions are coming in so fast. It is hard to keep up here. So, you can open at any broker that doesn't charge you commissions. Let's see. How's the execution speed? I don't know. I don't trade through Tastyworks. I don't. I trade through Tradier. But what these all of these trades are based on limits. Okay, I don't. You never ever want to go into these trades at market, ever. They will rob you. I don't care who you're with. All right. So I just patiently wait for my price to be hit. Let's see. That is, so your numbers are based on a short ATM and long always be $1 less. No, this was for example only. Okay. I gave you a couple of examples of a TPO pattern. Let's see. What do you do? Put these on Monday and Wednesday? Yes, you can, but I focus, especially with the beginners, I focus on Friday, Monday, because you can put together better prices than you can with Monday, Wednesday expirations, etc. Absolutely can be done. More information is right there. All right. I'm just scrolling through here. A lot of these I answered during the process. I have two platforms. One's an option analysis platform, and the other is a trading platform. PDS Trader or paydaystocks.com is my option analysis platform, and then my trading platform is Trade Partner. Phil, I gave you a real trade. Let's see. I'm just scrolling through here. I'm not clear on what I get. So here's what you get. Okay, Power of PPD video. It's an option instruction video. It's a foundational video so that you understand what we're doing, why we're doing it. Triple play option introduction video, where I go into more detail about why I pick the strikes that I pick and how to understand the relationship between the bearish and the bullish. Then a quick starter guide. where you can reference, or a quick reference guide where you can reference back to several patterns and look for those patterns week in, week out if you want. And then you can attend one of my live trade sessions. And that's where I take the trade live. Plus, you get the compounding plan, by the way, which is exact. You follow it exactly. And you do not want to deviate unless you know what you're doing. Yes, I have an entire course on money management and compounding, and that is found at fixedratio.com. Fixedratio.com if you want more information on that. Do I send alerts? Yes, I do. Let's see. I showed a link. So hopefully you got that, where you can get more information. Just scrolling through here. All right. If you call the phone number, leave a voicemail, and she will get back with you. Okay, there's the phone number. Leave a voicemail, and she'll get back with you. I think y'all can see the questions. General chat, I posted the link. So you can scroll there and find that. How am I exiting trades? That's an excellent question. Generally, as a limit, yes. So I exit the spreads the same way that I entered them, on a limit, as a general rule. Okay, but I definitely go into exits more in the live call sessions, by the way, as well. All right. Is there a monthly fee for the room? Yes. And Spring just... Spring just messaged me and said she didn't realize she'd be flooded with calls tonight. So bear with her. Let's see. Is the compounding plan the same as my 1 million 5-year video? No, it's not exactly the same, because this is a little bit more efficient of a strategy. How you actively manage the trades. Well, that's the great thing. You really don't have to necessarily actively manage the trades. You can, if you want, you can put these on and just be done with it until it's time to exit. You put your exit orders in and be done with it until it's time to exit. So no management necessary. Chris, I don't need your lousy $97. Do I call stocks? No, I do not. I am not that. You'll have to rely on Steven for that. I am not a stock picker. Been doing this for 30 years, and if there's anything I do know, it's that I don't know how to pick stock direction. And believe me, I've seen everything out there. So I'm just not good at it. I bring too much bias into it, which is why I focus so much on doing away with price direction in my SPY options. I don't want to have to pick direction. So just being totally honest there. No, this option strategy has not been available for very long at all. This is a brand new. Turning 1,000 into 3.7 million was not possible realistically with options prior to the Monday, Wednesday, Friday expiration. And again, it's only possible if you have the right type of trade. Do I get the videos immediately after you pay? Yes. Do I put an exit in for an automatic profit exit? Yes, you absolutely can do that. You don't necessarily have to do that, though. Becky just posted the link again. Thank you very much. All right. Attend the session and then you'll know. Do I offer a money back guarantee? You know what? If you take my trade and you don't, and you lose $97 on my trade that you take in my live session, yeah, I don't care. I don't need your $97. So if you, but I also am not giving away my strategy to everyone. So if you take the trade and you lose money with that trade that I give you in the live call that you attend, yeah, I'll refund your $97. I have no problem with that. Yes, if you sign up today, you can get your trade. You can get into the live trade session tomorrow. That is absolutely right. You'll be sent an email giving you instructions on how to attend the live trade session tomorrow. Monthly fee is $199. So you get 8 live session calls, but you get more than that. It's not just the live trade sessions, but it's $199. Let's see, GB, that's not how it works. His question was 3.7 million for 1K in 5 years is making 0.8% per day. That is correct, but that's not at all how this works. Okay, geometric growth is not making 0.8% today, but I will tell you that I made 30% today, so on my entire account, so there's that. let's see. Can this be done after hours? Yes, it can be. Obviously, my live trade sessions are during market hours. Yes, those are recorded, so you do have access to them as soon as we're done. So at any time you want to watch the recording of the live trade session, if you're not able to attend live, you absolutely can. How many of followers ever made any money? I have every single week, I get traders in the rooms that tell me how much money they made last week. And I'm telling you, if you follow my strategy, the probability is very high. It's not absolute. You can make mistakes, et cetera, et cetera. But you saw the you saw a couple of trades. You know what has to happen for them for a trade to lose, right? So I would only make an average of $50 a week if I cost. This is about compounding, Thomas. This is not about making a killing with the individual trades. It's absolutely about the compounding. Am I relying on using margin on your compounding method? So let me give you an example of the trade that the very first trade that I showed you, whereas the bear trade with the bullish trade, the margin on that was just over $100. All right, which is what the risk is. So there's no margin necessarily outside of the risk, and that's because the long options expire, after the short options. So that's why I say it can be done with very little money. $1,000 is not my recommendation, but it can be done. I've done it. You can definitely build your account from $1,000. But you want to take the lower risk trades, which is why I say you want to know how to do this. You want to learn how to do this because you can create these trades where the initial risk on a trade, for example, is only $50 instead of $150. And you would have to lose how many times on the types of trades that I showed you in today's presentation, how many times did you have to lose $50 in order to wipe out a $1,000 account? 20 times on trades that have 80, 85, 90% probability of making money, okay? So, and even smaller probabilities of suffering the maximum risk. Let's see, you can find the June 12th. Contact support, Victor, if you're already a subscriber. Do I recommend more than one contract or multiple contracts making 100 per contract? No. So you're probably not going to make $100 a week to begin with on these, because I'm going to recommend that if you're starting out, you go very slow and you take the highest probability trades. I've had traders that have, well, let me back up. The max profit potential on some of these trades is anywhere from $150 to $400. I had a trade on today, the max profit per lot size was $400. And I made that because it was the credit on the entire trade size. But I was also steering it to more bearish, all right? So again, you can structure these so that you have higher probability of making a small amount or a lower probability, but you're gonna make bigger profits. I tend to go with the higher probability in the trade calls because I know most of you are not, you know, don't have years of experience with my approach. What is the drawdown on this strategy? Depends on how you apply it. It's as simple as that. If you're applying it with the lower risk trades of $50, $100, your drawdown is going to be very small. If you're taking $300, $400 risks trades, your drawdown is going to be larger because there will be times where you lose money. Last week is an example where I lost money. First losing week that I've had in one of my smaller accounts that has been growing astronomically. Last week was the first losing week I've had in 10 weeks. So it will happen sometimes. And it just depends on what you focus on, higher probability or higher profit size. All right, terms of use, displays on previous. Let me see here. That's what you get, okay? All right. If you're risking $100 per spread, are you buying 10 spreads in your system? No, 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 no. Thank you for asking that question. Let me clarify. If you start with only $1,000, you want to take lower risk trades and you only want to do one combination. Okay, one bearish, one bullish. That constitutes one unit. You only want to do one. If you have $100,000 in your account, you only want to do one. And I know people balk at me and they don't agree, but I'm telling you, you start with one because the money management is where the growth is. You start with one, and as you prove yourself in placing these trades on properly and making money, that's when you increase your overall risk exposure. And that's when the geometric growth happens. You do not want to start with a $100,000 account, be willing to risk $5,000 on one trade, make a mistake, and then lose $5,000. You don't want to do that. Make sure that you have an understanding. This is the concept is simple, right? And I think everybody understands the concept. The execution is going to take you a few weeks. And depending on your experience level, maybe a few months before you really catch on. But it will click. I promise you that. It will click. Yes, the recording of this is available. You can also see something similar by going to the link that was posted. Here, I'll post it again so you don't have to scroll anywhere. This is only for SPY. All right. I think we've got most of the questions. Live sessions are, yes. So tomorrow, there's one slight difference because I had an event today, but they're usually on Monday and Thursday now, and they're on Thursday at 2:00 Eastern and on Monday at 11:00 Eastern. I'm actually doing today's tomorrow at 11 a.m. Eastern. All right. Looks like I got everything. Yes, this is a one-time charge. Sorry, Martin. Yes, this is a one-time charge, single payment. I will not renew it automatically. It's not one of those. I hate those. I know you guys probably do too. So Now, this is a one-time charge, $97. If you like what you see and you want to do whatever it takes to learn this stuff, which I would highly recommend, then you can go on to the monthly subscription. Yes, the live session tomorrow is being recorded, and if you join today, you will be sent that recording. You'll also be sent the instructions for how to attend the live session as well. Okay. All right, let's see here. Go to this link. So my normal link is paydaystocks.com, but you're not going to see this offer on it. Paydaystocks.com is the normal link, but that's the link that you would sign up for this offer. Okay. You get the recording session of one live session. Yes. And the reason is because I give way more information than is valuable for 97 bucks. I mean, way more. So you will have enough information to know, yeah, you know what? I absolutely do want to move forward with this more, or you know what? I don't. You don't believe me, you know, whatever. That's fine. Doesn't change what I do and what I've been doing, but you know, that gives you more than enough exposure to be able to understand that. Let's see here. Jerry, what about there? Just got here, what's an option? I don't know. I have no clue, actually. Could I delay attending a live session? Yes, CB, if you want to, absolutely. Just let, when you get an email, just hit respond to it and say, I want to delay my live session. When you sign up, just say, I want to delay my live session. They'll delay it for you. All right. Perfect. What time is the live session? Tomorrow, it's at 11 a.m. Eastern. No, if you sign up tonight, you will not be put into an auto-renewal. I get you guys. Believe me, I hate the auto-renewals. You think you sign up for a one-time thing to get your feet wet, and all of a sudden you're charged every month. No, that's not the way I operate. If you sign up for a renewal, you'll know it. All right, and this is not that. How many live sessions are you doing in a month? Between 8 and 9. And every now and again, I'll throw in a bonus recorded live session video, like I did about a week and a half ago. If I see something special and it's outside of my live session time, I'll do a recording of it real quick and send it out. I don't charge anything more for that. Each session lasts at least an hour, depending on what I've got going on. But a lot of times, I mean, I cover so much in these sessions. You'll learn just an astronomical amount. I answer every question. And so sometimes these sessions have been known to go on for 2 hours because I do answer the questions. Now, this is not a one-month subscription. Okay, this is a get your feet wet. You receive basically two videos, access to one live trade session and the recording of that live trade session, plus I give you a guide. So if you wanted to, you could just use that guide. If you think you understand it well enough, you can just use that guide all by yourself. I give you enough to do it on your own for just 97 bucks. Most people see the value in it fairly quickly, and the rest of it is well worth it, okay? Including the money management plan. I give you the money management plan in this $97 thing. If you sign up for a year, you get all recorded live trade sessions. And I've been doing them for about 3 months now. I told you this hasn't been available for very long. I am actually doing a I'm actually doing a 2-day live seminar at the end of July. It's online, with the COVID thing going on and all the travel restrictions. I decided to do it online, and that's going to be an intense workshop where I am doing nothing but this. That's going to be available as well. 1997, you basically get a $400 discount for 1 year. Yes, you can watch the recording sessions as often as you wish. Yep, you're probably looking at the right guy, Phil. Yeah, I have a YouTube. You can definitely subscribe to the YouTube channel. Absolutely. Are any of these sessions on the YouTube channel? No. All right, Stephen, I think I've gotten all the questions. So if you want to put
Very
this.
good stuff. Yep, very good stuff, Ryan.
Thank you, Stephen.
Everybody,
Appreciate it.
yeah, for $97, you're going to get a lot of information from the get-go. And this is something that is going to teach you a discipline that Ryan has put together that's working successfully. So we've often professed, or I often tell you all, a lot of people ask, well, when you do options, don't you check the data or the data, the delta and all that? No, we don't use any of that when we're trading options with candlesticks. So it's not outlandish to not have to worry about all the Greeks. And secondly, the thing that we've often professed is it's not trying to maximize your profit on every trade. It's the compounding effect of being in the correct trade with a high correct trade ratio. So all Ryan has done is put this into a very sophisticated discipline, I guess, category, so that you're doing trades, and it's not like you're taking your whole account and flipping over into the system. He's even telling you. You start off small until you understand it. So it's not like you're going to be changing your whole trading strategy. It's going to be taking a portion of your funds and putting into this system. So for $97, you're going to, from what it looks like, you're getting a lot more than what a lot more money's worth than what you're paying. And it's going to probably give you another view on how to keep your trading much more disciplined, and be able to, from what I gathered from Ryan's implication, that if he thinks so, there is a bullish or bearish bias to a trend or to a trade, you're going to be able to build that in using your candlestick analysis. So, Ryan, this is very interesting stuff. As a matter of fact, I'm thinking of buying a package myself just to see what the discipline is.
I
So,
appreciate that, Steve. It is fascinating. So I appreciate you having me today.
right, no problem. People try it, and if we get some good feedback, we'll have Ryan back here again. So with that,
Awesome.
Ryan, thank you very much. That's a lot of good
Thank you,
information. I
Steve.
know you were trying to pack a lot more information than the time constraints. So,
Yep, man, a lot of information. Appreciate it, though.
right, well, good. All right, everybody. Have
Thanks
a
a
good
lot.
evening. Thank you, Ryan. We'll see everybody in the chat rooms.